Well, we're certainly living in very interesting times, and no matter what else happens, this is going to be in the history books. You're going to be telling your children and your grandchildren that you lived through the 2020 coronavirus epidemic, and you're going to be talking to them about what life was like during that time. And one of the things that has certainly changed is meeting together. And we've live streamed for these past two, actually last Sunday, and we're going to be live streaming this Sunday. But as you know by now, due to the governor's order of a moratorium on gatherings of more than 10 people, our worship services are going to be live stream only now through April the 19th. And so pray for that. Pray for us for that. Pray for me for that, because we're going to be doing Easter Sunday live stream only, and that will certainly be very strange. And years from now, we'll be talking about the year that we did that we did Easter Sunday live stream only because of the crisis that we're in. But as we gather together to worship this Sunday, I want to talk to you a little bit about worship is and your participation in it. In the 21st century, the way that most churches approach worship, if you think about three components in worship, that the way most churches approach worship today is to think of it in this way, that there's a director, that there are actors, and that there's an audience. And the way that it's typically thought of is this, that God is the director or the prompter of worship, that the worship leaders, the people up front, they're the actors of worship, and the congregation as it gathers is the audience. And so it doesn't, you know, really matter too much whether that audience is there in person or whether it's there remotely, people are viewing it on the television, because they're the audience, and it doesn't matter really where that audience is located. But that's a mistaken way. It's not a biblical way of thinking about worship. If we think of it in terms of those three components of worship, the more biblical way to think about it would be that the worship leaders or the prompters or the directors of worship, that you, worshipers, are the actors, and that God is the audience. See, God is the one who the worship is done for. God is the recipient of that worship. So he's the audience. He's the one who observes it. He's the one for whom it's done. And the reason why it's important for you to understand that is this, because our worship, because it's not done for you as an audience, will really make no sense if you just sit in front of your TV and watch it. It will really be very boring. And the reason it will be very boring is, well, imagine if you went to a movie, but instead of watching the movie with the actors doing what they do, the camera was trained on the director, and it just showed the director pointing here or pointing there, cueing people for their lines, or telling them what they should do next, give direction. It wouldn't really be very exciting to watch. And that's what the worship leaders are in worship. They're the directors. It's you, the worshipers, who are the actors, and God is the audience. So it's important that as we worship together, that you be mindful that you are gathered, even though you're remote from one another, you're gathered together with your brothers and sisters in Christ, and you're carrying out those elements of worship. That in the responsive readings, you're doing the responses, and they'll be printed in the bulletin for you this week. In the singing of the hymns, that it's not a performance, that the people who are doing the singing and playing the music there, they're the directors to help you sing praises to God. In the recitation of the creed, in the praying of the prayers together, all of those things are things that you should be involved in and doing, because it really makes no sense to just sit and watch what you'll see on the video screen on Sundays, because we are not trying to put on a show. We're not thinking of you as being the audience. We're directing you so that you can carry out that drama of worship before and to the living God. So these are interesting times. I'm looking forward to things getting back to normal on the one hand. On the other hand, I'm kind of invigorated by the challenge. And I just want to encourage you to hold, to hang on, to hang in there. That I know that things are difficult. Some of you have children home that you weren't expecting to have home. Some of you are out of work. Some of you are having to stay home at work because the children are at home. And it's a difficult time. But God is with you. And if you've been receiving the communications, the church is with you. People are with you. We're checking on one another. So be encouraged. Be blessed. God will get us through this. And I'm looking forward to seeing you on Sunday. God bless you.